Hi, I'm Steve Butler. I'm a professor in the Department of Mathematics at Iowa State University. And I'm going to talk today a little bit about what mathematicians can do when they get to get involved with some games. In particular, let's talk about some juggling. So there are many different ways to juggle. In fact, as many as you want. There's always a new pattern to learn. And we want to talk about the simplest pattern, what we call the three-ball cascade, or as a mathematician would say, three. Three refers to the length of time that each throw takes. So in other words, you throw it up, and then three ticks later, you catch it. So there's a one throw, which is just a very fast throw. And you can think of one being as how much time it takes to get to the other hand. So that's one. So you can throw one, you can do this. You're already a juggler. There's a two throw. A two throw is a quick up and down. Now you go to the same hand because most jugglers, they have two hands. And so we think of it as alternating between hands. But it doesn't have to have two hands. If you happen to have three hands, the theory works just as well. But if you're a three-handed juggler, you probably have something much more interesting to talk about than just juggling with three hands. And so we start, we throw it, we catch it three later, and we're going to throw it three again. But in the meantime, there's other throws going on. So there's a three here, and there's another three, and there's all these threes going all the way down forever. Well, that's a little bit about juggling. There's still a lot more to learn. There's a lot of interesting things to say. But in general, math is the study of patterns. Juggling is just one way to think about patterns. It's a beautiful subject. I'll see you soon at Iowa State.